Very warm welcome to our Interim Alternate Digital Solution webinar. Trinity has brought out this alternative solution in response to the COVID-19 situation. These are really extraordinary circumstances, and Trinity has developed digital solutions so that your learning and teaching does not stop. So let's have a look at what this alternative is. Most of you would have received information from your area representatives. This is available for classical and jazz grades initial to 8, for performance diplomas, ATCL, LTCL, not FTCL, rock and pop grades initial to 8. So these are the subjects it's available for. It's also available for drama, but today we are doing the music one. It applies to already registered candidates who may have already deposited fees for exams in April, May, June, and even July, and also for new candidates who would like to apply. Now, the name given to this is Interim Solution. So there is going to be a deadline to this. For the grade exams, it means that you video your 3 pieces or 4 pieces, because in singing, we sometimes do have to do 4 pieces as stipulated in the syllabus. This will be uploaded to our portal and marked by an examiner remotely. Trinity will calculate your exam result, the full exam result, based on the marks given on your pieces. And then you will receive the normal regulated certificate that you would get in a face-to-face exam also. Now, diploma exams, here it's a filmed performance of your complete program. So as per the syllabus, if you're an ATCL, between 32 and 37 minutes, whatever's given in the syllabus. The whole program has to be done. Candidates who are doing exams for accompanied instruments will be allowed to play solo or with a recorded accompaniment, or of course with a live accompanist. Because of the circumstances, we are giving these options for the diplomas as well as the grades. However, Trinity recommends that accompaniment be used, whether recorded or live. If not possible due to the way things are, you may choose the solo option. Now, we have adapted syllabuses on the website for this qualification. And these are more like information booklets. So we have one for classical and jazz, we have one for rock and pop, and one for music performance diplomas. Now, these contain all the requirements for this digital exam, as well as details on how to upload and what to upload. You can download these from the website if you want. We can send you soft copies if you mail us. It is possible. Please remember that the learning outcomes and assessment criteria will remain the same. These do not change. Okay, now a little look at the marking scheme, because we are only submitting our pieces. So where are the rest of the marks going to go? We are not submitting any technical work and not doing any supporting tests. So on the left of your screen, rock and pop, song 1, normal marks 25, song 2, 25, and technical focus 30. That leaves us with the session skills. And if you notice, it says here, you get a calculated percentage for that. We will go into details about this soon. For the classical music, the normal marks 22, 22, 22. The technical work and supporting tests also will go into a calculated percentage, which will be 34 marks. That's your 14 for the technical work and 20 for the supporting tests. Now, how are these going to be calculated? Let me just give you a little details about that. These are going to be calculated by looking and hearing your pieces that you are performing. Trinity's exams carry appropriate construct coverage. This means that within the recital component of the exam, many of the skills usually tested through our technical work and supporting tests are also demonstrated. You would know that in classical music when you look at the breakup of the pieces. In music, the skills that you need to be able to play the scales accurately, such as instrument control, sense of pulse, are also demonstrated within the performance of the piece. And these get marked in the boxes under accuracy and fluency and technical ability. So the examiners have been trained again to draw the marks for this out of your pieces. That's partly how you will get the marks for your supporting tests and technical work. Secondly, what Trinity is doing, they're using statistical tools. This includes historical data, analysis of the data according to region, where you are, and syllabus, instrument, and grade. And also from the live validation database, where we look at the trends in result data. It's a bit like artificial intelligence used here. And these scores put together will be marked as your calculated marks for your session skills in rock and pop and for your supporting tests in and technical work in the classical music. The theory exam now. The May 2020 theory exam has been postponed to November 2020. There will be two dates in November so as to accommodate both the sessions. Now, this also depends upon the situation that we are in November regarding the COVID. In case we are still not able to get together, then we would have to think of further postponement. There will be an additional theory session in February 2021. Now, there's one more thing here. If you have already prepared for a grade in the May exam, you want to move on, you can upgrade yourself to the next grade and pay the difference in fees to your center. So that's about the theory exam. Now, as far as the exams go, what are the options we have just now? Of course, what we've been discussing, the digital assessment, but this is time bound and only available till 31st July. You could wait for face-to-face exams to resume, or there is another digital assessment which will be a permanent product and will be launched in August, and you could take that. This will continue even when the face-to-face exams resume. We will provide details about this product as soon as we receive them from London. Now, a little bit about recording. This is all new to all of us. We've never done it this way. You can record at home or with your teacher or at your school. Now, recording with your teacher or school depends upon what the situation in your city is. Your performance needs to be filmed in one take. Do not edit or join separate performances together. You can record as many times as you like and choose the best for upload. And my suggestion is that if you are opting for this, You should start experimenting from now and seeing what are the best settings that you can make on your camera or your phone or your tab. We want the best possible result in the recording. There are detailed filming guidelines on our website. This is the link to it. If you go to our website, you have to go to the coronavirus page and then you will get all the links for guidance. To register, there are dates for this. The last date for entry is 17th July 2020. The last date for upload is 14 days from the time you receive the link, or 31st July, whichever is earlier. So the way this works is that you will receive a link from Trinity, giving you a username and a password, which I will give you details about a little later, to which you have to upload your performance. Now, if we talk about 31st July as the very, very last date, so 14 days from the time you receive the link, or 31st July, whichever is earlier, which means that in case you receive the link on the 24th of July, you don't get 14 days from then, you have to upload by 31st. So the earlier the better. Make your entries and start working towards uploading as soon as you can, because you don't want to leave it for the last day. There may be internet problems, there may be some problems on that side or the London side or here. We know how this works. Now for UCAS points, if people want to use for college admissions this year, that's the 2020 to 2021 academic session, the last date for entry is 25th June. And the last date to upload your performance is the 10th of July. So this is only for those wanting to apply your UCAS points for admissions this year. Your UCAS points will be given for grade 6 to 8, but if you're using it this year, these are the dates. Now, how do you register? Entries to be submitted via email to your local customer support office. Candidates who are already registered and have paid the fees will have to confirm if they want to take the digital solution. Your entry does not automatically transfer to the digital solution. You need to confirm it. And all candidates need to provide email IDs. Teachers can facilitate this. And also, if you're an REC or you have a big bunch of students and the teacher would like to upload the entries himself or herself, you can give one email ID and it'll all go from your email ID, the school email ID or your email ID. But each performance has to be uploaded separately. You cannot upload in bulk. Now, payment. We have some very good news here, which is not only for this session, this interim solution, but we now have the facility of accepting a direct bank transfer via NEFT. And all details for this will be available with the local exam center, your customer support office. The exam fee remains unchanged. The current fee structure 2020 to 2021 applies. There have been questions on this, and there will be questions on this because people are asking why it is not lowered since the examiner is not traveling and he's not having to bear hotel expenses, center expenses, center venue expenses. Now, there's one thing here. To get this digital solution off the ground, Trinity has had to invest a lot. Trinity has done a lot of research so that we get it absolutely right and conform to Ofqual requirements, since the certificate being given is going to be the same as a face-to-face exam. Trinity has invested in servers which will accept these uploads. So there's a lot that has been invested in this. However, we are hopeful that when the new digital product comes, the next one, the permanent one, we may see a slight lowering of fees. But we are not sure about that yet, but we do expect that. For now, it is the same fee. A little bit guidance about instruments. For piano exams, you may use a digital piano up to grade 8 or even an electronic keyboard up to grade 3. However, please keep in mind that these instruments must have all the facilities needed to realize the musicality of the pieces that you are playing, which means you need pedals on your digital piano, maybe even attached to your electronic keyboard if you are doing grade 3. Sometimes you need pedals. The electronic keyboard must have touch sensitivity, especially from grade 1 and 2 onwards. And it must have enough keys to accommodate the pieces, the notes of the pieces that you have chosen. Now, what you have chosen, you must make sure that everything can be played on your electronic keyboard. If not, you can't alter the pitch of a note just because you're playing on the keyboard. So please be careful of that. For drum kit, electronic drum kit may also be used. For accompanied instruments, you can play solo or with accompanist or with recorded accompaniment, as I mentioned, for the diploma exams. If you are playing solo, please remember if there are rests of more than 3 bars, you may omit it and carry on to the next phrase. For rock and pop exams, one of the assessment criteria is how you play with the backing track. So pieces 1 and 3 have to be played with the backing track. No solo performances here. Piece 2, if you choose the own choice or the own composition, you have the option of playing without a backing. You can play solo. For vocalists, you may sing without a mic. We understand the limitations when you are doing an exam from home. So that's the bit about instruments. Carrying on about the pieces. If you're doing a duet, which is there in our classical music syllabus, you can ask your teacher to record the duet part and play along to that in the exam, or you play solo. Backing tracks, the person filming can help you, or you can have another person in the room to operate the tracks. Now, very important is to check the balance before you start the recording, especially for vocalists who are performing without a mic. You have to make sure that your backing track doesn't overpower your voice. A little bit about original book, because there has been questions about this. Sometimes you may not have the original book at the moment. It may be with your teacher, or you may have thought that you would buy it just before the exam. For this solution, this interim solution, you may use a scanned copy. However, you will need to destroy this after the recording. You must destroy the scanned copy or the photocopy after the recording, because there are very strong rules about copyright, and this is only allowed for this time, just for this solution, not at any other time. Now we move into the filming segment. Let's look at the room. It needs to be quiet with no external noises. Mobile phones should be on airplane mode. It should be well lit Now, lighting is important because if you have a light behind you, you will be in shadow and nobody will be able to see the examiner. It doesn't matter about anybody else, but the examiner will not be able to see you perform. So avoid bright light behind you. Music stands must not obscure the instrument or the candidate. There should be enough space to perform effectively, and all electrical equipment such as wires, plug points must be safely plugged in or taped to the floor. You have to conform to the safety norms. We don't want any accidents happening here. Now, what are the devices you can use to film? We want to make it as easy as possible. So you could use your smartphone or tablet or any good quality audiovisual recording device. We recommend the use of a tripod for stability, but if you do not have access to it, you should place your device on a steady surface, or the person holding it must keep it steady. If you look at the topmost picture on the left, you will see that the device has been placed on a music stand. So you can improvise there as long as it remains steady. Camera needs to be positioned at the performer's eye level so that the examiner gets the full unrestricted view of the performance. It should, as far as possible, be a recreation of the exam room that you do a live exam in. Now, I'm reiterating again about the continuous take of the video performance. It's got to be one take. You cannot do any editing. To ensure that the size of the video can be managed by the platform that you will be uploading it to, lower the recording quality before you begin by turning the HD off, if possible. Your smartphone or camera should have enough charge and enough storage to record your performance. So all these are on a checklist before you start. Now you make sure once you filmed your video that you play it back to make sure that the sound and picture quality is good enough for the examiner to mark it. If not, you can re-record. A little bit about the uploading. If you're uploading directly from a phone or tablet, you'll probably need to compress the video so that it meets the criteria for the portal. There are many apps that can help you do this. So if it's from a phone or tablet, for iOS, you can use Compress Videos and Resize Videos. For Android, you can use Video Transcoder. If you are uploading straight from the computer, then this is a little flyer of what you should be doing. And for a PC, you should go on to mirovideoconverter.com/download. The link is given here. This flyer is on our website. So you have to download the Miro Video Converter. There are four steps here. You open the video converter. Once you've imported the video, you select Format Video MP4. Click on Convert to MP4. After that, you click on Show File, and you will be taken to the compressed video file, all ready to be uploaded. So these details are all on our website. Now, also the size of the videos we spoke about, and this information is given on the website. Initial and grade one is 50 MB, then 200 and 300 MB, and so on, till grade eight is 300 MB, and diplomas are 350 MB. You need to ensure that your video and any of the accompanying documents are not more than 1 GB in total. You can upload your video and the documents in the following formats: MP4, MOV, JPEG, DOC, DocX, PNG, PDF. Any other format will not be eligible for upload. The site will reject it. So make sure it is in this format. Now, what do you have to upload? Of course, the performance pieces. If in the classical music you are choosing pieces from an alternative list, or in rock and pop you're doing an own choice piece, you must upload the score of that piece along with the recording. You will also need to upload a Word document of the names of pieces and composers for classical music, for rock and pop, name of piece, artist, and your own choice and technical focus songs must be marked clearly. It's a bit like your appointment slip, the details that you provide there without providing any details for your supporting tests. Now, for candidates below 16 years, we require a parental consent form signed by the parent. The local customer support office will be sending you this form once you confirm that you have entries. And any candidate below 16 years must upload this form along with the rest of the items I have listed. If you have a supporting letter to notify the examiner about any exceptional circumstances, such as special needs or allowances, you need to upload that too. Your file has to be labeled as below. There'll be your name, underscore classical, and the instrument, underscore grade, and the number. That's for the classical, and R&P for rock and pop. So for example, in the next band, I have given an example. Ankita Chopra, underscore classical piano, underscore grade 2. For rock and pop, Joseph Lal, underscore R&P guitar, underscore grade 4. So these instructions are all given on the website. Another word of caution, do not delete your video till you have received the feedback report and certificate. In case there are some technical issues and you need to resubmit at any stage, so please hold on to your video. There is a detailed video guide to uploading on this link at the bottom. And if you go to our website, you can go to the tab saying booking and you will find this link there. The video is hosted there. It is also on YouTube. So you upload your final performance video and documents to learning.trinitycollege.com using the username and password that Trinity will provide you, and via a computer or phone or tablet or directly from your recording device. So just to summarize before we end this, you perform your three pieces of songs, you record your performance in one continuous take, you upload your performance video and supporting files to a link provided by Trinity, and you receive feedback and marks followed by a regulated certificate. The feedback and marks will come to you on your email ID provided. The certificate will come to the center and will be dispersed by the center. So you appear for the digital exam, you can get your qualification and move on. The main idea here is to facilitate your learning process and to have no breaks in this, and also the teachers also get a chance to continue their teaching when they are preparing the students for the exam. So thank you very much for choosing Trinity. This is the end of the presentation. I am going to stop the screen share. You can write to us or your customer support office for any queries you may have, but at the moment we are going to look at the questions and the chat. and try and answer as many as we can. There are a lot of people standing by who would have answered these already. We have Farida, Gopal, and Priya on this webinar with me. A lot of people were not able to come in. So if your friends were not able to come in, we will be sending around another webinar information date very soon, probably by this evening, so they can join that. So let's move to the chat now. If you want to unmute yourselves, Farida, Gopal, Priya, and let me know if there's anything I need to address. If anybody would like to speak, I can unmute you, but it might be a little tedious because there's 106 people on this webinar and I'd have to look for the person to unmute. So I suggest you put it on the chat. Any questions here?
Yes, ma'am. There was a question on the violin exempt accompaniment. Happens in some of the pieces, there would be the accompaniment for a lot of parts where the violin is taking rest.
So I gave that that reply, didn't I?
If the candidate is playing solo.
Yeah, I gave that reply. I said if the rests are for more than 3 bars, you can omit it and move on to the next passage. I did say that. Is that all right?
Fine, yes. This was around 20 bars, basically.
Yeah, so beyond 3 bars, anything beyond 3 bars, you just carry on with the playing.
Okay. That was from Ashna.
Okay.
I have a question about how to record with backing tracks. Someone said that I don't know how to do that. And another question is that it's not possible to have a kind of soundproof room. And in trying to do that, there will be a resounding effect or an echo effect. And will that affect the marking? I mean, how important is it?
See, we do know that you are recording in extraordinary circumstances and exceptional circumstances. So definitely we would, Trinity would make allowances for that. But as far as possible, you don't need a studio to record. Start experimenting from now. You don't need a soundproof room. We have done recordings just sitting in our music room and from our phone we have recorded and it's proved to be pretty good quality. So do experiment. My advice is to start experimenting from now and see what is the setting that suits you the best. And just for that period of time, you can have that setting. Yes, Priya.
There have been a lot of queries about the process. I think that we need to advise all that all is explained on our website. They are still not sure as how will Trinity provide the password and username.
Let's take it one by one. Just to recap, I did tell you will make your entry providing an email ID to your customer support office. The customer support office will enter you on our Trinity Online portal with your email ID. Once we submit that order, Trinity takes it from there and will send you on your email ID. It's going to come to your email ID, so make sure there are no mistakes in your email ID. They will send you the username and password. Our office then has no role to play. It's up to you to upload on that. And the result also will come to you, not to us in the customer support office.
Another recurring question that we're getting is, I think this needs to be again reiterated. Can the videos be recorded on different days? Can I join the videos? I think
we need I to have said this things. Three yes, times, I think, in the presentation. Yes, it's an unedited, continuous recording. Please try and recreate the atmosphere that is there and the norms that are there in the exam room. Nothing else. Instead of the examiner, you have somebody recording you, recording the candidate. So no editing is allowed whatsoever. If it's edited, Trinity will get to know and you will be disqualified.
The other question that has been asked 2 or 3 times is, a little concern about the size have a diploma question. If my size is zero, it's that long a performance.
Well, obviously, Trinity has researched this and only then given the 350 MB size.
Yes.
They must have put in some thought and got some advice from experts and put in that advice. This length of time is what you are recording for. Maximum is 37 minutes, I think, for ATCL.
Yes, it's not 45, certainly.
That's yeah. So will it be enough, the size of the file? And obviously, they have confirmed that it will be.
Yes.
And just continuing with the same LTCL, how to submit the music sheets to the examiner for LTCL drums exam? And a second part of the question is from the same attendee about the backing tracks, man, for the classical suite for the drums, though we say solo is allowed. For the drums, I think we have to get back on that.
Yes, this is a question that I got earlier also when I was doing this webinar. I think I need to check about the drums, but I think for the classical drums also, you would be allowed to play solo. They have not made any exceptions. But in case it is not, please accept that yes, it is solo, only classical drums, not rock and pop. But if it is not, then we will get back to you.
Because the question is, can the backing track be placed over the solo performance by making an edit on the software?
I think we also you can't edit the software at all, but you can have the sound being recorded on, Gopal, will you take this? What was it? Digital audio, something, DAW?
At the digital audio workstation.
Yeah, workstation.
That was, I have answered Shashwat's question also there.
Yeah.
How to record that. So either that could be done straight with the video recorder, straight from outside, or we can give the audio, the art performance and the backing tracks to the system. The performance has to be live and the audio output can come from the system. That's what it means.
Yes.
Anjali, there's a question I'd like to address.
Yes.
Do I also have to play the technical work or just the three songs?
Now, I have reiterated this also. There is just no technical work, no supporting test. Yes, Farida.
Yeah. And that's the one. And there's also, what are the options if the candidate doesn't want to go with this option? Will they be allowed to have face to face? That also has been answered. We are not sure about the situation being viable for a face-to-face exam even at the end of this year. It all depends on the situation in India. So it's a wait and watch situation. It may still be digital at the end of the year and you'll be notified well in advance about that.
Okay, anything else?
They want to know what is the meaning of a permanent digital assessment. I think we need to tell them it is like any other exam, the certificate will be the same. And they're concerned that will the certificate be valid? Will it say that it was an online assessment on the certificate? Or will it just be like any other Trinity certificate?
I think we answered that also in the presentation. If you were listening, the certificate is exactly the same. There will be no other mention that it is a digital assessment. It is going to have exactly the same format as your live face-to-face assessment. There's a question here from Athar saying, can the videos of different pieces be recorded on different days? Obviously, no.
I think we are getting confused when you said that you can make as many recordings as you want and choose the best on different days.
But a continuous recording.
Yes, it has to be the whole.
And there was a question on piano tuning.
Yes, I did say that you could go to your teacher's house if that is allowed. If that is not allowed, maybe you can get a tuner in. I think now there is no permanent lockdown anywhere. I think Chennai has gone into lockdown today, but I don't know what are the rules. But in other places, yet there is no lockdown and people are being allowed to come in and maybe tune your piano. And there is no other alternative. If you cannot get to a good piano, then you just have to wait. Please don't do it on, my advice is don't do it on an untuned piano, because it will affect the result. Of course, if you have a digital piano, there is no problem, because digital pianos don't need tuning.
And there is no question of degree. Some have said if it's only slightly out of tune. I think that's a difficult decision to make, how slightly out of tune it is. So
that's all right. If you feel it's, you know, your teacher can advise you on that, because the teacher will be hearing your pieces, whether it's online or it's live. So the teacher can advise you on that.
And again, the question has come, do the pieces have to be recorded continuously? I think we need to...
I'm not going to answer that question again.
I think it is that they need to go to set up for rock and pop. That is perfectly part of the examination, as it would be in a live exam. Whatever setup has to be done per piece, but it should be there on the recording.
See, the setup will be there. Your setup will be complete. Your sound check should also be complete before you start recording. You could do your sound check before you start recording, because you are in control over the sound, not an examiner. So finish the sound check and everything, and then start the recording.
I think we could make it a point to say that please imagine that your room, as you have already said, is the examination room, with the only difference that the examiner is not physically present and will be examining afterwards. Otherwise, everything else should be like a live exam. For the three pieces.
And when you put down the list of pieces, please put them in the order that you are playing or performing them, not in a random order, because the candidate is not going to speak at all. Candidate is not going to announce the pieces. Any other questions?
Yeah, is it compulsory for accompaniment for violin? That also has been answered.
Yes.
Not so compulsory.
Then we should not repeat these questions.
Okay. I guess so. I think it's all.
Ma'am, just I yes, want ma'am. To highlight you. Highlight you. There are few people are joined now. The limit is enhanced, so there are around 50 people are joined. Just inform them we are planning to have one more. What to say tomorrow? Possibly we'll need to work out.
Yeah, because we'll need to give the others a little also notice, those who have not been able to join today. So we will have another webinar. We could fix it for tomorrow morning.
My suggestion is tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning, but we need to inform everybody, Soumyan.
Yeah, we will
have to send out the information immediately today.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those who have joined now, please, we won't be repeating it right away. So tomorrow morning, we will send you information.
And or you
contact your center, wherever you got the information from. We'll also put it out on social media.
One of the queries that has come repeated two or three times is, what is the option if we don't want to go with the digital assessment?
I have said that in my options slide. You can wait for the face-to-face exam.
Exactly. So the answer question is...
You can wait for that. Yes. It may happen sooner than later, because there are local examiners being recruited and trained at a very, very fast pace. So you may just have Indian examiners examining you. So there's a question from Sonal saying, what is to be done in case the candidate has prepared a duet? I answered this in the beginning of the presentation. I said that the candidate can play the part solo, or the teacher can record the accompaniment and the candidate can play along with the accompaniment. Of course, if you are allowed to be there, you can play along with the candidate. But with social distancing, it's not going to happen.
There is a question maybe for Gopal. Is Shashwat again? Is DAW?
Shashwat, if you could contact us, if you have my email ID, if you can send us a mail about this, I'll get you all the details about DAW. from our expert. We'll ask Mark to send out a mail for this. So Shashwat, if you have my email ID, if you don't, please tell me here. Gopal, can you just type? Type the email ID in the chat. Anything, you know, because we can't go into so many details here. And we will address it as soon as you send us a mail. There is somebody who asked, in rock and pop drum, do we have to play impression? I think he means improvisation or reading playback. No session skills required. No session skills.
How to record with a backing track on electrical drums?
Electronic drums. The backing track is going to be playing from outside.
Same thing.
It's not going to be, the drums are not going to be playing it. The backing track will be from outside.
Yes.
We are trying as far as possible to create a document with all these points, and we will mail it out to all those who do apply. There is a question here saying, can you reiterate the marking scheme? 3 rock and pop pieces. Yes, 25, 25, 30. The balance 20 marks go to a will be given as a calculated percentage, which I spoke about in detail, and it is on our website also. Please, I strongly request you to go to the website and read. All these details are there. I have just, you know, kind of summarized it all, but every little detail you're asking about is there. Yes, we will try and make the recording of this webinar available. Do I have to sing with the backing track for the second piece? Well, depends. If your second piece is from the book, this is Lombok. Second piece is from the book, yes, you need to sing along with the backing track. If it is an own choice piece, it is given in our syllabus that you may do it unaccompanied. Or if it is an own composition also, you can do it unaccompanied. I've paid fees and I don't opt for this solution. No, obviously you will not pay fees again. Your fees will be carried over for the next live session.
A lot of people would like to have a recording of this webinar. They have requested.
Yes, yes, there is a recording, and we will send it out. I'm hoping the attendees are there. Could you all mail me if you want a recording? Because I may not have all the email IDs of the participants.
And the criteria has been explained, but there are questions as to what is the basis of assessment. We've said that there are certain parameters that Trinity has put into place after due research, and that criteria will be applicable.
Now, somebody said, I have paid the fees, but I've lost the acknowledgement slip. I'm sure your center will have details of the fee. But if you have not sent the proof of payment to the center, you could maybe get a bank statement or something and send it to the center. If only hands are visible in the video and the exam book, is it fine? It's preferable, please, to have the candidate fully visible and the instrument.
I've said all filming requirements have been explained in full, and they can additionally visit the site.
Also, Sunil Chauhan asked, how will we name the file? I gave all the details in the presentation. Yes. It is there on the website also. Somebody says that would refund be surely done? Well, if you want a refund, please contact your Trinity customer support office. They will deal with that. Shashwat is asking, ma'am, I didn't receive your email.
I have put it there. I have typed it
in the chat.
Is only on question and answer sometimes.
No, but you can put it on the chat.
Okay.
Just put it on the chat and he can access it from there. I'll type it right here also. Any other questions, Gopal, Farida?
I'm also answering from here.
Sorry?
I'm also answering some of them.
Okay.
I'm typing the answers, most of them.
Okay.
Most are repeated questions that we've already answered.
We have typed in most of the answers.
The format of the Word file to be sent with the songs and how to attach the consent form. How to attach? Well, you will
soft
have...
Soft copy or hard copy? I think it just says soft copy.
Soft copy, obviously. Soft copy has
to go. Question was hard or soft copy?
No, so there is a question on Q&A from Shweta. So the Word file format is a Word file. I am not understanding this.
Ma'am, my suggestion is any other query, please ask them to write to the local customer support office, which
yes.
will be taken care by the, us and forwarded to the academic and get the clarification within 24 hours.
Yes, so. I think that is a better idea.
Yes.
Please write
yes.
to your customer support office and you'll get all the answers within 24 hours because time is short. We
yes.
don't have a lot of time before these exams to enter.
Yes.
So you have put email address. I'm sorry, Shashwat, we will not be able to unmute you. Please mail me and I will, you can give me your number, I'll talk to you. Yes, Sonal, a scanned copy will do. Violin exam we have addressed. Sure, we'll send out the recording, Sudha. Those who have joined late, we are going to be doing another webinar tomorrow morning. We will send you the information this evening. Please keep watching your mails or look on social media and you will find the detail for it. Exercise for drum kit not needed. Criterias for marking, please visit our website if you missed out today.
I have done that already, yes.
LTCL pieces should not be done on a digital piano. We mentioned only up to grade 8.
Yes.
That has to be an acoustic. You can do it on an acoustic or a baby grand, whichever. Okay, I think we're done with most of the questions.
Yes.
As Soumyan said, please mail your customer support office if you have more questions. They will address them almost immediately. Thank you very much. And we will fix up a time tomorrow morning and have this webinar all over again. And if necessary, even next week.
Yes.
So please tell your friends. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe and happy teaching, I hope. Bye-bye.